Hello and welcome to Skyvia Tutorials. In today's video, we will check how to sync data between Oracle and Salesforce with no coding. We picked three common data integration scenarios for this tutorial. Sync data from Oracle to Salesforce and vice versa, replication of the Salesforce data to Oracle for further reporting and analytics, and utilizing Skyvia Connect with Salesforce Connect to access data from Oracle DB and Salesforce in real time without loading it. This tutorial assumes you already have a Skyvia account. If you don't have it, you can create it for free by following the link in the description. Before you start building integrations between Salesforce and Oracle DB, make sure to create a connection to each of them. To create a connection to Salesforce, click New, select Connection, choose Salesforce, and log in with your credentials. There are two ways of creating a connection to Oracle DB. Direct and through the agent. Use direct connection if your Oracle DB is accessible through the internet. To create a direct connection, click New, select Connection, and look for Oracle DB. Enter the server's address, port, and select Connection syntax. Then enter the service name, username, password, and choose the role to log in with from the Connect as dropdown. If your Oracle DB server is located on your local computer or network, use Agent Connection. In this case, Skyvia will connect to the database server via agent application that acts as a secure layer between Skyvia and your database server. To create a connection through Agent, you need to download the Agent app first by clicking New and choosing Agent. From here, download it and install it on your computer. Also on this page, you can see your agent's key. Copy it to paste in the agent's UI once you run the agent app, or download it and place it in the same folder with the agent app, so the key will be inserted automatically. It's also recommended to name your agent, so you will be able to locate it easily in future. Once you've downloaded and installed the agent app, let's create a new connection. Click New, select Connection, and look for Oracle. Select the agent connection mode at the top. Choose your agent from the drop-down list and enter your Oracle DB credentials. While using the connection through agent, make sure that the agent app is launched. If nothing happens when you launch it, right-click on it and choose Run as Administrator. Now, when connections to Salesforce and Oracle DB are created, we can move to the examples. Let's start with integrating data from Oracle DB to Salesforce using Skyvia Import. Let's take the case of an e-store that has two channels of sales, website and sales team. Opportunities generated through the website go to the Oracle database, and the one generated by the sales team to Salesforce. With Skyvia, you can sync this data easily in both ways by using Import. To sync opportunities from Oracle DB to Salesforce, click New and choose Import. Select Oracle DB as source and Salesforce as target. To define what data to load from Oracle DB to Salesforce, where to load it, and how to map it, create an import task by clicking Add New. You can add any number of import tasks to your integration. Let's import opportunities by selecting the Opportunities table from the drop-down list. Here you can optionally apply filters to your data. For example, let's choose only opportunities with a close date, March 1st or higher, and click Next Step. On the target definition page, select the opportunities object in Salesforce to load data into, and one of the available operations. Insert adds source data to target. Update updates the values in target according to values in source. Upsert combines insert and update operations and adds new records while updating existing ones. Delete deletes the records from target. As we want to load opportunities from Oracle DB to Salesforce, and there cannot be any duplicates, we select Insert Operation and click Next. Skyvia tries to map fields automatically. However, you can remap any field as you see fit. There are four mapping types available: column, constant, lookup, and expression. Let's use constant and set the opportunity type to new customer. Once this is done, click Save and Create. Now you can run your import, schedule it for future runs, and check the current import execution and the results of your previous imports. Let's create a schedule for it, then run it and check the log details. We schedule the integration to run every week on Monday at 9 a.m. London time, starting now. To check the results of the current and past integrations, use Monitor and Log tabs. If some rows fail to import, you will receive a detailed error log. Also, you can set up email notifications to receive in case of partial or complete failure of your integration. You can import data from Salesforce to Oracle DB in the same way by creating another import integration with Salesforce as sourced and Oracle DB as target. Additionally, if you like to visually build ETL pipelines, you can try Skyvia's data flow. It is developed to handle more complex data integration scenarios. However, it is also suitable for simple scenarios like the current one. Here is the same import scenario made with the help of data flow. Here we select all opportunities from the Oracle DB and apply filter by closed data and load them to Salesforce. As an additional little step, we add a custom field that stores both the name and description. Now, let's move to our second scenario. For the second case, we chose a scenario of complete replication of Salesforce data to Oracle DB for data analysis and reporting purposes using Power BI, Tableau, or any other BI tool of your choice. To replicate your data, click New and choose Replication. Select Salesforce as source and Oracle DB as target. Click Show All and select a checkbox to mark every object for replication. If you are interested in a specific object, you can check only it for replication. All the fields of selected objects will be replicated by default. If you want to replicate specific fields only, click Edit. Here you can manually mark fields for replication and apply custom filters. If you have new replication runtime enabled, you can select replication modes per object and hash-sensitive data if needed. Replication modes that are available are Standard, which is assigned to each object automatically and applies the default replication behavior. Resync, which forces the full replication of the object by dropping and creating a table in target during each replication run. Resync on demand, which is created for objects that are part of your replication but are not required for each replication run. With resync on demand, you can include the object in the next replication run by resetting its last sync time. There is also a history mode. Use it to track the history of the entries in your database. Enable it for the chosen objects in source to store every change made to the object's rows in target using the type 2 slowly changing dimension. It basically adds few more fields to your object that help to keep multiple versions of the same rows and check the status of the row and its changes during a specific period of time. Skyvia supports hashing field values to conceal sensitive information when loading data to databases and data warehouses. To hash a field, hover over it, click Unhashed, and select Hashed. Once done with configurations, click Save. Additionally, you can customize integration-wide replication options. Enable incremental updates to include only changes applied to data since the last replication run. Select the Update Schema checkbox to apply data structure changes made in the cloud app to the database schema in target. Also, you can choose to create or drop tables. Note that when the incremental updates are enabled, tables will be created only during the first replication run. Once this is done, you can run or schedule your replication as you see fit. Let's schedule the replication to run every day at 7 a.m. Paris time. After you run the replication, you can check the execution status and its results on the monitor and log tabs. Here you will see the number of successfully replicated rows and error messages in case something went wrong. For our third scenario, we chose a case when you need to get real-time access to your Oracle DB data in Salesforce without loading it into Salesforce. This scenario can be useful when you are either facing compliance issues or you want to minimize Salesforce storage expenses by accessing your data through the OData endpoint created with the help of Salesforce Connect. Let's check how it works. You create an OData endpoint for the table in Oracle DB and create a custom object in Salesforce. With the help of Salesforce Connect, you link your custom object with the OData endpoint to get access to your Oracle DB data without loading it to Salesforce. To do so, click New and select OData endpoint. Choose Simple Mode to define the endpoint model and look for Oracle in the list. Define the endpoint model, select the objects to publish, and optionally adjust OData entities. Configure endpoint security settings and click Save. Don't forget to name your endpoint and adjust additional settings if needed. Copy your endpoint URL as you will need it later. The next step is to create an external data source in Salesforce. For this, log into Salesforce and go to Setup. Under Platform Tools, click Integrations and then click External Data Sources. Choose New External Data Source. Enter values for external data source and name boxes. In the type list, select Salesforce Connect, OData 4.0. Paste the copied endpoint URL into the URL box. If you created user accounts with passwords for your endpoint in Skyvia, you also need to configure authentication settings. Set identity type to named principal, authentication protocol to password authentication, and specify the endpoint username and password. Click Save and then click Validate and Sync. Select the endpoint tables you want to sync and click Sync. This will create the necessary external objects automatically. After defining external data source and external objects, you may add tabs for external objects in order to work with them via Salesforce UI. To do so, go to Setup and under Platform Tools, click User Interface and choose Tabs. In the Custom Object Tabs pane, click New, select the required object, and set the tab style and description. Specify the tab visibility settings and configure the tab availability for custom apps. That's all. Your tab is ready, and now you can work with your external objects. Thank you for watching the Salesforce and Oracle DB integration tutorial. If you still have any integration-related questions, drop us a comment below and we will help you. To try Skyvia for free, use the link in the description. See you in the next videos.